First question is, what is the maximum number of distinct handshakes that can happen in the room with 5 people in it? To solve this question, apply the formula like n into n minus 1 over 2. Here n will represent the total number of people present in the room. Here we have 5 people that is present in the room. 5 into 5 minus 1 over 2. We get 5 into 4 by 2, that is equal to 10. So the option B is the correct option for this question. Next question is, a train running at a speed of 60 km per hour crosses a pole in 9 seconds. What is the length of the train? As we know, speed is equal to distance over time. Now the speed of the train is given and the time taken by the train to cross the pole, that is the length, that is the train will cover the its own length in 9 seconds. So the time is 9 seconds, speed is 60 km per hour, and we have to find the distance, that is the length of the train, and we have to find the length of the, and the options are given in meters. So first of all, we have to convert the speed in meter per second. Now the speed is in 60 km per hour. To convert the speed in meter per second, multiplying it with by 5 by 18, here we get the speed of the train, that is 50 by 3 in meter per second. Now we have to find the distance, that means distance must be equal to speed into time, and the speed is 50 over 3 and the time is 9 seconds. Here we get the length of the train, that is 150 meter. So the option D is the correct option for this question. And the next question is, the percentage profit earned by selling an article for rupees 1920 is equal to the percentage loss incurred by selling the same article for rupees 1280. At what price should the article be sold to make 25% profit? So the percentage profit earned, that is 1920, when selling the same article, the loss occurred by selling the article for rupees 1280. To find the CP, what you have to do, you have to add these prices, that is 1920 plus 1280, and divided it by 2, we get CP, and the CP is equal to rupees 1600. And what we have to find, we have to find at what price should the article be sold to make a profit of 25%. Now the CP is rupees 1600 and we have to sold the article to make a profit of 25%. So the CP is 1600 and the profit percentage is 25%. So multiplying it with 125 over 100, we get the SP, that is equal to rupees 2000. So the option A is the correct option for this question. Next question is, a boatman goes 2 km against the current of the stream in 1 hour and goes 1 km along the current in 10 minutes. How long will it take to go 5 km in stationary water? Let us take the speed of stationary water, that is equal to x. Speed in stationary water, that is equal to x kilometer per hour, and the speed of current, that is equal to y kilometer per hour. The first statement says boatman goes 2 km against the current of the stream in 1 hour, that is x minus y is equal to, this is the speed in stationary water, speed of the current is equal to 2 km, that is distance, and time is 1 hour, or you can say 2 km per hour. This is the upstream speed. Now downstream speed is, that is x plus y is equal to, the boatman goes 1 km along the current in 10 minutes. The distance is 1 km and the time is 10 minutes. To convert it into hour, that is 1 by 6 hour, or you can say 10 by 60. The speed is equal to, downstream speed is equal to 6 km per hour. And we have to find the speed, and we have to find how long will it take to go 5 km in stationary water. Now first of all, we have to find the speed in stationary water, that is x kilometer, we have to find the value of x. Now we have x minus y, that is 2 km per hour, and x plus y, that is equal to 6 km per hour. So here we get 2x is equal to 8. And x is equal to 8 by 2, or you can say 4 km per hour. Now, the distance is given, it is 5 kilometers, and the speed of the stationary water is 5 kilometers, and we have to find time, that is equal to 1 is to 1 by 4 hour, or you can say 1 hour 15 minutes. So the option C is the correct option. Next question is, the present ages of 3 persons are given in the proportion, that is 4 is to 7 is to 9. 8 years ago, the sum of their ages was 56. Find their present ages in year. Now the present ages of 3 persons are given in the proportion, that is 4 is to 7 is to 9. Suppose the persons are like A, B and C. 8 years ago, the sum of their ages was 56. That means at present, the sum of their ages is 56 plus 8 into 3. That is, there are 3 persons. So 56 plus 24, that is equal to 80 years. This is the present ages of 3 persons. Now, the present proportion of A, B, C is given, that is 4 is to 7 is to 9. Adding these, we get 20. This 20 unit will represent 80 years. That is the sum of their ages. The 1 unit will represent 4 years. That means the present age of A is 4 into 4, that is 16 years. The present age of B, that is 7 into 4, that is 28 years. And the present age of C, that is 9 into 4, that is equal to 36 years. That means option B is the correct option. Next question is, a tank is filled by 3 pipes with uniform flow. The first 2 pipes operating simultaneously fill the tank in the same time, during which the tank is filled by the third pipe alone. The second pipe fills the tanks in 5 hours faster than the first pipe and the 4 hours slower than the third pipe. The time required by the first pipe is? The options are 6 hours, 10 hours, 15 hours and 30 hours. Suppose there are 3 pipes, pipe A, B and C, and the first 2 pipes are operating simultaneously, fill the tank in the same time, during which the tank is filled by the third pipe alone. That means if first 2 pipes are A and B, from this statement it is clear that A plus B is equal to C. That means the efficiency of A plus B together is equal to the efficiency of C alone. Now, if C is taking X hours to fill the tank, that means B is taking X plus 4 hours, because the second pipe fills the tank 5 hours faster than the first and 4 hours slower than the third pipe. That means if C is taking X hour, that B will fill the tank in X plus 4 hour, and A and the second pipe fills the tank 5 hour faster. That means A will take X plus 5 plus 4. That is, A will take X plus 9 hours to fill the tank, because if C is taking X hour and B is taking X plus 4 hour and B fills the tank 5 hours faster than A, that means A is taking X plus 9 hours. To solve this question, apply a short trick. The extra hours taken by A and B together, that is 9 and 4, multiplying this 9 and 4 and take their square root, that is 36, and the hours are, that is 6 hours. This will give you the value of X. Now, if C is taking 6 hours to fill the tank, that means B will take 6 plus 4, that is 10 hours, and A will take 6 plus 9, that is 15 hours. And what you have to find, the time required by the first pipe is, that is 6 plus 9, 15 hours. So the option C is the correct option. Now the next question is, a rectangular field is to be fenced on the 3 sides, leaving a side of 20 feet uncovered. If the area of the field is 680 square feet, how many feet of fencing will be required? Suppose this is a rectangular field this side is uncovered. To get the other sides, divide this area, that is 680 with 20, we get 34. That means this side is 20 feet, and this is the rectangular face, that means this side is also 20 feet, and remaining two sides are 34 feet and 34 feet. Now we have to find how many feet of fencing will be required. Remaining this side, that is this is the uncovered side, add all the side, that is 34 plus 34 plus 20, we get that is 88. So the option D is the correct option. The next question is, seats for mathematics, physics and biology in a school are in the ratio, that is 5:7:8. There is a proposal to increase this seat by 40%, 50% and 75% respectively. So what will be the ratio of increased seats? The ratios are given, that is for mathematics, physics and biology, that is 5:7:8. Suppose the seats for mathematics is 500 and for physics that is 700 and for biology it is 800. Now the seats are increased by 40%, 50% and 75% respectively. So direct take the 140% of 500, 150% of 700 and 175% of 800. After solving this, we get the ratio, that is 700:1050:1400. It can be further solved and we get the ratio, that is 2:3:4. This is the ratio of the increased seats. So the option is the correct option. The next question is, a flagstaff 17.5 meter high casts a shadow of length 40.25 meter. The height of the building, which casts a shadow of length 28.75 meter under similar conditions, will be. So the height of the flagstaff, that is 17.5, and cast a shadow of length, that is 40.25. That must be equal to the height of the building. We have to find cast a shadow of length, that is 28.75. After solving this, we get x is equal to 12.5 meter. So the answer B is the correct answer. Next question is, find the odd one in the following series for question number 11 and 12. The question number 11 is, 6 terms are given, that is 396, 462, 572, 427, 671 and 264. We have to find the odd one out of the series. So the first term is 396. In this, the first and third number is the sum of the middle number, that is of the second number, that is 3 plus 6, that is equal to 9. Similarly, in 462, the first and third number is the sum of middle number, or you can say second number, that is 4 plus 2 equals to 6. Similarly, 572, the first and third number is the sum of the middle number, that is second number, that is 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. The next term is 427. In this term, first and third number is not the sum of the middle number. So that means the option B is the correct option for this question. Now the next question, next terms are given in the series, that is 2, 5, 10, 17, 26, 37, 50, 64. The gap between first two term is 3. The gap between the next two term is, that is 5. The gap between 10 and 17, that is 7. The gap between 17 and 26, that is 9. The gap between 26 and 37, that is 11. The gap between 37 and 50, that is 13. The gap between 50 and 64, that is 14. So here you can see the gap between the term is a series of odd numbers in increasing order, except the gap between 50 and 64. That means the number 64 is not suitable here. So the odd one from the series is the option D, that is 64. The next question is, the difference between simple and compound interest compounded annually on a certain sum of money for 2 years at 4% per annum is rupee 1. The sum that is in rupees is, the options are 625, 630, 640 and 650. For this type of question, apply the direct formula, that is, the difference between SI and CI must be equal to the principal into R, that is the rate per annum, thus taking the square of R and dividing it by taking the square of 100. So the difference is rupee 1. We have to find the principal. The rate is, that is 4% per annum, taking the square of 4, dividing it by 100. After solving this, we get P is equal to 4 into 4 over 100 into 100. That is, P is equal to rupees 625. So the option A is the correct option. Now the next question is, complete the missing element of the following series. So the option for this question is the option C. Next question is, 4 terms are given in the series and we have to find the next term. The first term is J, A, K. Next is K, B, L. Next one is L, C, M. Next one is M, D, N. We have to find the next term in the series. So the first alphabet in the first term, that is J, and the first alphabet in the second term, that is L, first alphabet in the third term, that is L, first alphabet in the fourth term, that is M. So here you can see the alphabet is increasing by 1. So the next alphabet in the next term will be N. Second alphabet in the first term is A. In the second term it is B. In the third it is C. In the fourth it is D. So these alphabet, that is the middle alphabet of the first, second, third and fourth term, are increasing by 1. So the next alphabet in the next term of the series, that is E. And the third alphabet in the first term is K. The third alphabet in the second term is L. And in the third it is M. And it is in the fourth it is N. So that is, it is also following the same pattern as that of the previous one, that is increasing by 1. That means the last alphabet in the last term, that should be O. So the correct option for this type of series is, that is NEO, that is option B. Next question is, the 4 terms in the series is given and we have to find the next term, that is F A G, G A F, H A I A H, and we have to find the next term in the series. So the first alphabet in the first term is, that is F, second is A and third is G. From all the terms of the series, you can say middle term is constant. So the middle alphabet is constant, that is A. The first term you can say, the next alphabet to F, that is G in the alphabetical series. And next, second term is the reverse order of first term. And in the third term, the next alphabet to G, that is H. And the next term to H, is that is I. And the fourth term is the reverse of the third term. So the next alphabet that should come in the series, that should be J. And A is constant in all the terms. Now the next next alphabet in the series, that should be K. K. Because in the series, the next alphabet to F is G, the next alphabet to H, that is I, the next alphabet to J, that is K. So the correct option for this series is, that is option A, that is J, A, K. Next series given, that is Q, A, R, R, A, S, S, A, T, T, A, U. You can see the alphabet A is constant in all the terms. So the middle term of the next term, so the middle alphabet of the next term, that is A. Now you can see the alphabet next to Q, that is R. And in the next term, the first alphabet, that is R, and the next to R is, that is S. In the third term, the first alphabet is S and the next to S is, that is T. In the fourth term, the first alphabet is T and next to T, that is U. So in the next term, that is first alphabet, there should be U, and next to U, that is V. So the option A is the correct option. Next question is, if GORBLFLUR means fan belt and PIXNGORBL means ceiling fan and ARTHTUSL means tile roof, which word could mean ceiling tile? So from the first two statements, you can see the word, that is GORBL, is common, that is, and fan is common, that means the code for fan is, that is GORBL. And in the second statement, the code for fan is GORBL, that means the code for ceiling is PIXN. Now we have to find the word that which could mean ceiling tile. In the third statement, we have ARTHTUST means tile roof. Now the code for tile is cannot be determined. So the option D should be the correct option, because the code corresponding to the ceiling is PIXN, and the option D is starting with the code, that is PIXN. That means D option should be the suitable answer for this type of question. Next question is, get odd one out. Four options are given. Option A is Y, W, U. Option B is N, L, J. Option C is K, I, F. And fourth one is V, T, R. Now the options are Y, W, U. Now we see here the gap between U and W is of one alphabet, that is V. Similarly, the gap between W and Y is of one alphabet, that is X. Now in the second term, N, L, J, the gap between J and L is of one alphabet, that is K. The gap between L and N, that is of one alphabet, that is M. And in the third option, that is K, I, F, the gap between F and I, that is of two alphabet, that is G and H. The gap between I and K is of one alphabet, that is J. Now, the next term is V, T, R. The gap between T and R is of one alphabet, that is S. The gap between V and T is of one alphabet, that is of one, that is U. Now accept all the option, the gap between the alphabet is of one alphabet, except the option C. So the option C is the correct option. Next question is, two students appeared at an examination. One of them secured 9 marks more than the other and his marks were 56% of the sum of their marks. The marks obtained by them are, the options are option A, that is 39-30, option B 41-32, option C 42-33 and option D 43-34. We will solve this question by taking the options. So the gap between first and second number, that is of 9. Now the person who secured 9 more marks than other, and his marks were 56% of the sum of their marks. So the total of sum of 39 plus 30, that is 69, that is equal to the, by taking 56% of 69, that should be equal to 39, but the number is not equal to 39, so the option A is not the correct option. So we'll go for the option B. The gap between 41 and 32, that is 9. When we taking the sum of 41 and 32, it comes out to be 73. And to find the 56% of 73, that is not equal to 41. So the option B is wrong option. When we go for option C, that is 42 and 33, the gap between the two number, that is 9, when we take the sum of these two numbers, that is 42 plus 33, it gives you 75. When we take the 56% of 75, that is equal to 42. And we have given the statement his marks were 56% of the sum of their marks. Sum of their marks is 75 and 56% of the marks, that is 42. That means the option C is the correct option. Find the number of the triangles in the given figure. When we count the number of triangles in the figure, we get the maximum number of the triangle, that is 14. So the option D is correct option. The next question is, choose a figure which would most closely resemble the unfolded form of figure. So the option C, or you can say figure 3, is the correct option for this question. Each of the questions 46 to 50 are based on the information given below. 8 persons E, F, G, H, I, J, K and L are seated around a square table, 2 on each side. There are 3 ladies who are not seated next to each other. J is between L and F. First statement is J is between L and F. If I placed F here, then J is between F and L. G is between I and F. G is between I and F. H, a lady member, is second to the left of J. H, a lady member, is second to the left of A. First left of J is L and the second left of J is H. That is a lady member. F, a male member, is seated opposite to E. F, a male member, seated opposite to E. If I place E, that is E is placed opposite to F. E, that is a lady member. There is a lady member between F and I. F and I. That means G is a lady member. The remaining one is K. K is placed here. Now the question is, who among the following is to the immediate left of F? Immediate left of F, that is J. So the option C is the correct option. Next question is, what is true about J and K? J and K, as lady members are H, E and G. Lady members are H, E and G. That means J and K both are male. The option D is correct option. Next question is, how many persons are seated between K and F? That is, How many persons are seated between K and F? That is, 3 persons are seated between K and F. So the option is C. Who among the following are three ladies? The three ladies are E, H and G. So the option C is the correct option. Who among the following is seated between E and H? E and H. So K is seated between E and H. So the option C is the correct option. Next question is, three ladies X, Y and Z marry three men A, B and C. Three lady, that is X, three ladies, that is X, Y and Z married to three men, that is A, B and C. Next statement is, X is married to A. X is married to A. Y is not married to engineer. Y not married to engineer. Z is not married to a doctor. Z not married to doctor. C is not a doctor. C is not a doctor and A is lawyer. A is lawyer and C is not doctor. Only monogamous relationship are permitted, then which of the following statement is correct? If C is not the doctor, that means B should be doctor and C should be engineer. C is engineer, B is doctor and A is lawyer. The option is, and if Y does not marry to engineer, that means Y married to doctor, that is B, and Z married to engineer, that is C. The options are, Y is married to C, who is an engineer, but Y is married to B, so the option A is wrong. The second option is, Z is married to C. Z is married to C, who is a doctor, but the profession of C is engineer. So the option B is again wrong. So, and the option C is, X is married to a doctor, but X married to a lawyer, that is A. So none of the option is correct. So the option is D.